Hey guys, Backyard Scrapping here. What I figured I was going to do is just do a small series on recovery. This is things that anybody can do. I mean, if you have the material, it doesn't require any chemicals. It's just it's time consuming, but very simple. I mean, it doesn't take anything but your time. The first one I'm going to do is going to be on computer connectors or, little plugs and stuff that comes off of the circuit boards. And it's going to be pulling the pins and harvesting the pins and then showing you what I do with my own stuff. I mean, I don't process those. I will process, full plated pins. I'll process them for you or for myself. But the pins that have just the little tips that have gold plating on them, generally I will not process those unless the ends have been cut off. In other words, unless the dead metal has been removed. So that's what this first video is going to be about. Then I'm also going to, I've had a lot of people asking me about stripping the silver-plated silverware, so I'm going to show you a couple ways to do that, and you can do it without chemicals or anything, harmful. Then that would be the stuff that you would want to save up to send to me or someone like me to have refined. Enjoy. I hope you learned something from it. If you have any questions, as always, I'll be happy to help you out and, tell you what I can tell you. So have a good one, guys. Enjoy the videos, and we will see you later. Now what we're going to do is we're going to trim them up. So not only do I have to pull them, then I have to trim them. So what I do is I get on here and I see, okay, they're plated to about right there. So that's all the valuable metal there is on that whole thing. See, that whole pin is waste. And you have to dissolve that if you don't do this. And like I said, I only do this for my own personal stuff. See, just them two little tips, I don't know if you can see this very well on this camera, but just these two little tips are plated to about right there. So that's all I'm taking. There's no point in me dissolving this whole pin for those two little tips. And the same with these littler ones. Okay guys, we're back. I just wanted to show you, here's our basically a box of connectors, probably about a half gallon baggie full, and this is what we ended up with. And now this is what I wanted to talk about. Okay, these, it's always nice when you get this. When you get this, you can't beat it. That's full gold plate pins. You don't have to do a thing to them but process them. On the other hand, they're not all like that. But now this is what I wanted to show you. This is the waste metal off of these pins. This is the ones that the tips are just plated on. This metal has no gold on it. It's just worthless. So why do we want to spend the money on the acid, especially if we're going to do this with nitric acid? Why would we want to dissolve all that metal? Every gram of this metal that has absolutely nothing on it and is totally worthless basically is going to take a milliliter and a half, possibly a milliliter and three quarters, maybe even 2 milliliters per gram to dissolve. What I want to do is I want to show you how much waste there is. All right, in here, which basically, pins are the worst yielding of just about anything you're going to do. But what I ended up with here is 14.22 grams of processable material. In other words, if you were to send me that, I would process that for you. If you were to send it to me attached to this, I would not. But that's 14, so we got 14.19 grams. That is basically just going to be just as easy to process as this. It's going to take about the same amount of acid as this will take and whatever. If we had left them on there, there's twice as much. There's 31.49 grams of totally wasted metal here that you would have to dissolve with your acid. There is no point in doing that. Now granted, this takes a lot of time to do this. You have to hold each individual pin, cut the end off, but I'm just showing you material that I will accept and material that I will not accept. So there it is. I just turned basically a worthless material into a processable material. But normally this is what I would want somebody to send me. I wouldn't want them to send me these boards. Like I said, we're doing this just for a video purpose. This is what you would send me, and I'll show you what it looks like when it gets here. This is just an example, but this is a kilo of just the fingers of the RAM chips cut off. So you can see, this is how I would want material sent to me, or even broken down further than this is fine if you wanted to go ahead and take the foils off and just send the foils. But I will process them like this. Okay, but not normally like this. Like I said, this is just for the purpose of a video. So if you want to send me foils to process, this is what you're going to send me. You're not going to send me a whole board with, you know, the foils attached that I have to cut them off. Okay, so what I want to talk about here is the fees, or what I charge and what most home refiners charge to refine your material. Now, the object of it is for you to send as clean a material as possible. We base our, it's usually a 25%, 75% split. In other words, I'm going to get 25% of the yield, you're going to get 75% of the yield. The object is to send the cleanest material you can so you can get as much as you can out of it. Like with these contacts, I mean, they can yield, contacts are anywhere from 10% silver, they can be as high as 90% silver. These are probably going to be a little bit more silver. These may actually be tungsten, just a heavy, heavy, heavy coating over tungsten. I don't know yet until I do it. But the point of it is he has done his homework. He cleaned them up, he got them ready for me, instead of sending me something like this, which, I mean, I can't even refine that for you. The cleaner the material that you start with, the less acid it takes to dissolve things. In other words, the purer the silver is, the less nitric acid it takes. Now, nitric acid is fairly expensive, and then you have to pay hazmat shipping fees and all that kind of stuff in it, unless you live close to a chemical place where you can go pick it up. But I mean, just a hazmat shipping is $50 or more. So just an example, 2.2 liters of nitric acid cost me about probably 68, so let's just call it $70. The cleaner the material you start with, like if I'm using just pure silver, like to make this silver nitrate, that was pure silver. You see how clear that is? That's because there's no copper, there was nothing. It takes a minimal amount of nitric acid, about 1.2 milliliters per gram of silver. The more impurities there are in the silver, the more nitric acid it takes. In other words, for example, if it was sterling silver, something like these, this is sterling silver flatware or whatever, it's going to take 1.5 milliliters, maybe 1.75 milliliters to dissolve this stuff. Okay? Sterling silver jewelry, the same thing. Anything that's going to be sterling silver, it's going to take a little bit more. If it's coin silver, it takes a little bit more acid. In other words, the less pure silver there is, the more acid it takes, so it's a higher cost. Okay, our fees are based, like I said, 25% goes to me of the yield, 75% goes to whoever I'm refining it for. Out of my 25%, I probably only end up with about half of that as profit, and you can't really even call it profit because the amount of time it takes, you never get paid for your time, okay? A lot of people are asking me about plated. Now, this is sterling silver, so it's 92.5% pure. This is plated. There's very little silver on this. There may be a gram and a half of silver on all this. Unless you have tons of this type of material. These are all also silver plated. Unless you have tons of this material, I can't refine it for you. It just doesn't pay. There's just not enough silver in it for what it's going to cost me in acids and basically time. It's going to take even longer to do this stuff than it does to do the sterling silver. But there are some ways that you can still get the silver out of this cheaply. You can, for example, just take sandpaper and sand it off, or take a grinding wheel or a motor tool, someplace where you can catch the grindings in a tub, in whatever, and you can literally just grind this off. Now, it's not going to be pure silver because you're taking off other metal with it, but that's what you would want to send me. If you have, you know, a couple hundred pieces of this, and you sand it all off and grind it all off,
and get all the silver off into a powder, you can send me that powder, and then I can refine it for you. This is the same principle with this stuff. You can sand it off. You can also do what's called reverse electroplating. Basically, the material you want to send me needs to be semi-processed. In other words, it can be, this doesn't have to be, because this is just going to get cut up and thrown right into the acid. Same thing with this. Coin silver, I do have people that have asked me if I would do their coins for them. You can do that. I mean, your constitutional silver, unless it's really burned out like this thing, I mean, there's no date, there's no nothing, it has absolutely no collector value at all. Yeah, I would say if you want to refine that into pure silver, that's fine. It's 90% silver, so that could be refined. But you're still talking about material that is at least 75% pure or more. Once it falls below that 75%, you got to figure my end, half of what I get off of my end is already going to cover acids and materials. What's left of that, no way covers my time, but I don't do it for the money. I do it for the silver. I mean, I like silver, so, and that's also, like I said, it's my hobby. But like I said with this stuff, if you want to refine that, that's fine. Your constitutional silver, something that looks like that, there's no point in refining that. I mean, everybody knows what it is. You're going to probably get more for it like it is than you would if you refined it. Now, foreign coins or foreign money, there's all kinds of it. There's all kind of different amounts, 50%, 10%. You know, so the older Mexican pesos, they're about the size of a silver dollar, but they're only 10% silver. So again, you got to have a lot of those if you want to get anything out of them. But the point I'm trying to make is I would be happy to refine any of your material. You just have to get it to me in a semi-processed form. In other words, you can't send me this to refine. It costs me too much in acid. I'm probably not going to make anything. You're not going to get anything back. But if you were to take and do this for a year, every time you get two or three pieces of this and you sand it off, or you use reverse electroplating and you get the silver and you hoard that up, and then at the end of the year you send it to me, yeah, I'll probably get a couple ounces. You'll probably get a few ounces, you know, or whatever. If you send me 10 ounces and it ends up 10 ounces pure, you're going to get 7.5 ounces back, because that material that you're sending me is going to be over 75% pure. If it falls below that, in other words, if it comes down below that 75%, then I have to take a half a percent for each percentage below 75% of purity. So let's just say this came out 50% pure, these contacts. The base is 75%. If this comes out 50% pure, then I have to take a half a percent for every percent below 75% purity. And that is basically just to cover the cost of my acids. What I do is dangerous. I don't recommend anybody do it. I've been messing with metals for 30 years. I would suggest doing your research if you want to do this. The acids you're handling with, the fumes that are generated, are literally deadly. So, you know, it's not something to play with. If you don't know how to do it, you haven't done your research, it's definitely not something you want to just jump into and do. Another thing I want to tell you, just because it's marked sterling doesn't mean it is sterling. I actually did 500 grams of sterling jewelry one time, a half a kilogram. So in a perfect world, 500 grams should have yielded 462 and a half grams of pure silver. I got less than 400. That's because a lot of times it might be marked 925 or sterling, but it may only be 900. It may only be coin silver. I've had things that were marked 925 that have turned out to be 80% silver. So that mark is not set in stone. Anybody can buy a stamp and anybody can mark something whatever they want to mark it. In fact, I've even had pieces that were marked sterling and they were plated. So just remember that too. But in any case, I wanted to go over that with you guys real quick. I wanted to explain some of the refining. I mean, if you got coins and you want them turned into, I don't care. If they're your coins and you want to turn them into pure silver, I'll be happy to do it for you. 25% of the pure silver is going to go to me. 75% is going to go to you. Same thing with sterling jewelry. Same thing with contacts. Now, these are probably only going to be 50%, so it's going to cost him another 12.5%. But like I said, that's basically going towards acid. This kind of stuff here, you're talking about a 75% return to you. So anyway, I wanted to explain this to you guys a little bit, see if I could make it a little clearer how the refining end goes and what the processes are that we have to do. This is worth messing with. It's not worth it for me to do it all. If you prep this material, save it up. Like I said, you can sand it off. You can grind it off. You're going to have whatever metals underneath mixed in. That's why you get it refined. That's why you send it to somebody like me so you end up with this. That's what you want to end up with from this stuff, from any of this. You want to end up with pure silver. Don't throw this stuff out. I mean, there is silver on it. There's probably, I would say on this right here, gram, two, three, there's probably a couple 3 grams of silver on here. So if you're sitting around watching TV or out in your shop or whatever and you just want to sit with, you know, grinding paper or sand and sand the silver off of it, keep the little pile, throw it in a bottle, save it till you get a bottle full, sooner or later you're going to end up with quite a bit of silver. So anyway, guys, I just wanted to fill you in on that, explain how some things work. I will refine whatever you want to send me. Like I said, if you have coins and you want them refined, I'll refine them. Doesn't make any difference to me.